Hi students, welcome. Very good afternoon to you all. Today we are going to study about regulation of aldosterone secretions. We are going to study about the aldosterone secretions. So we know that aldosterone is synthesized in adrenal cortex and from zona glomerulus. Apart from aldosterone, there are many steroids that are secreted from the GF, that is zona glomerulus. But the most important hormone is aldosterone. So we will see how this, we will see the regulation of this hormone, important hormone, which is aldosterone. Okay, so this is K plus load. K plus load means when in serum you have, or in plasma you have more potassium load, that is known as hyperkalemia. Okay, that is hyperkalemia. That will stimulate zona glomerulosa cell. Okay, and that will produce aldosterone, right? Now this is one of the stimulus. This hyperkalemia can stimulate ZG to produce aldosterone, right? Now there are many other stimulus that can produce aldosterone. One of them is the angiotensin 2, and you know how it is formed. From the liver, angiotensinogen converted in angiotensin 1 by the renin enzyme, which is renin, and angiotensin 1 is converted into angiotensin 2 by the enzyme ACE, angiotensin converting enzyme, right? Now angiotensin 2 can stimulate the production of the aldosterone, right? Sometimes you have sodium deprivation, when your sodium is less, that is hyponatremia, when you have hemorrhage, upright posture. In all these conditions you have hypovolemic condition, right? Hemorrhage, sodium deprivation, so loss of oncotic pressure, upright posture, that is gravity pulling your fluids. So in all these conditions you have less extracellular fluid volume, and that will cause the kidney to secrete renin, and renin will convert angiotensinogen into angiotensin 1. Okay, first the RAS system, renin angiotensin system. The principal function of aldosterone is to maintain ECF volume. Okay, this is very important. What is the principal function? Maintain ECF volume, right? Means extracellular fluid ka volume ko maintain karta hai by conserving the osmotic product, that is sodium. Sodium causes osmosis. So this, because of sodium, by conserving the sodium, by retaining the sodium, or by reabsorption of the sodium, they can maintain the ECF volume. Hence secretions of aldosterone is influenced by changes in circulating volume. If your circulating fluid volume, whether less, whether more, that will have a important impact on the secretion of aldosterone. On the sensing organ, if you say about the sensing organ for sensing the hypervolemia, increase in plasma volume or decrease in plasma volume, is the kidney. Kidney is the sense organ for sensing the fluid volume. Now when the kidney receives this signal, or when kidney senses the condition of the, or the nature of the volume of the ECF, the signal arises from the kidney, increases the aldosterone secretion when ECF volume is decreased, and vice versa. So when it is decreased, then aldosterone secretion is, when the volume is decreased in ECF, alteration secretion is increased to retain your fluid. Now, what are the condition that is associated with? What are the condition that is associated with decreased ECF? Extracellular fluid kam hoga sharir mein kaise? By having sodium deprivation. When you are restricting much, dietary restriction, you are caring for your diet and you are not taking the proper sodium. So that can have a lower oncotic pressure in your fluids or your blood vessels, and that can decrease not only the blood vessels but extracellular spaces also. When there is a less oncotic pressure due to the sodium, so there will be deprivation. Okay, and ECF fluid will be decreased. Hemorrhage can also causes, it can also cause decrease in ECF. Upright posture for several hours, gravity is the culprit. Acute diuresis. Now, diuresis is the term which means that frequent and more micturition. So, if when we say acute diuresis, so acute diuresis is something when it is forced micturition. And forced micturation is done by some medicine also. There can be diuretics that can cause forced micturation, forced acute diuresis. So in acute diuresis, more and there is possibility of more and more fluid to be lost, and that causes ECF decrease in ECF. Now, what are the steps involved in the secretion of aldosterone by renin angiotensin system? Decrease in ECF volume leads to decrease in renal arterial blood flow and pressure. So, ECF decrease leading to the renal arterial blood flow pressure. Decrease in renal perfusion pressure. There is always a pressure that is created in the blood vessels of any organ, and since it is kidney we are talking about, so renal perfusion is decreased when there is a decrease in blood volume, right? So when the blood volume is decreased, renal perfusion pressure is causes JG cell of the afferent arterial to secrete renin. So this is the JG cell which secretes the renin, R-E-N-I-N. It is not R-E-N-N-I-N. And you all know better know that R-E-N-N-I-N is present where? In the stomach. Okay. So juxtaglomerular cell of afferent arteriole secretes renin in if there is a decreased renal perfusion. Renin catalyst the conversion of angiotensinogen to angiotensin 1. Okay, and angiotensin 1 is converted to angiotensin 2 by ACE, A-C-E. That is an angiotensin converting enzyme. ठीक है, बहुत important enzyme है, जो कि बहुत बार frequently MCQ से पूछा जाता है कि ACE is synthesized where? It comes from the lungs. It's not present in the kidney, right? Angiotensin 2, now it binds to receptor that is present in Jonah globulosa cells, and they increase the secretion of, they stimulate the secretion of aldosterone by action of conversion of cholesterol to pregnenol. So this the pathways from cholesterol to pregnenol and pregnenol to the corticosteroids, these pathway is stimulated by aldosterone. In addition to the increasing secretion of aldosterone, angiotensin 2 also exerts other effects in controlling ECF volume and pressure. Okay, and what are these effects? So, angiotensin 2 not only secretes aldosterone, but it have other effect. Other effect means what? The angiotensin 2 can also act as vasoconstrictor. Important function, vasoconstriction. Blood vessels may constriction karayega angiotensin 2. Beside this. And angiotensin 2 ka bahut role hai muscle contractions mein. Okay. So main, but the main function here we are talking about is the secretion of aldosterone. Now, aldosterone secretion may be increased 4 to 8 times by this RA system, renin-angiotensin system. And daily aldosterone, if you talk about, it is secreted by this mechanism, may vary from 50 milligram to the 250 milligram. We have talked about this in the starting of the chapter of aldosterone, that it depends upon the sodium intake. If the sodium intake is 150, okay, then you have 50 mg secretions, milliequivalent. And if your sodium intake is 10 milliequivalent, your secretion will be 250. Okay, that means the more the consumption, okay, the more the consumption, the less secretion, the less consumption of sodium, more secretion of aldosterone. Now, what are the factors that affects the aldosterone secretion by this RAS system? So, the first is sympathetic neural activity. Sympathetic neural activity. It enhances the renin release in response to hypovolemia. So, when there is a hypovolemia, your sympathetic system will also be stimulated, and this sympathetic system causes kidney to release renin. Now, there are local prostaglandins. There are local prostaglandins that can stimulate renin release. Therefore, anti-prostaglandin drugs can reduce aldosterone response. So, there are some local prostaglandins are the substances that are present, you know, that are synthesized from the, you know, membrane lipids. They are the lipid family. They are from the lipid family. So these prostaglandins have various roles in inflammation, infections, in edema, in constriction, dilatation. They have effect on blood vessels. So mainly the prostaglandins causes vasodilatation, right? So when there are local prostaglandins can cause renin release, that means locally in the JG cell and around, if there is a hypovolemia, local prostaglandins produced around the JG cell will cause this JG cell to produce renin. And therefore, for reduction of some time aldosterone, we can give anti-prostaglandin drug. The anti-prostaglandin drugs that we can give to reduce this aldosterone response. ANP, this is atrial nut uretic peptides, ANP. Now, atrial means it is synthesized in atria of the heart. It goes into the blood. Nutriuresis means it increases the excretion of sodium, and peptides means it is a protein complex. So atrial nutritive peptide that augments or reinforces the effects of RAS system. So for RAS system to stimulate, they are ANP, they are local prostaglandins and sympathetic neural activity. Now, it can also be controlled by plasma potassium concentration. So it's a very potent factor for regulating the secretions. And there exists a vital negative feedback relationship. There occurs a vital negative feedback relationship between the plasma potassium concentration and aldosterone secretion. See, basically aldosterone, it reabsorbs sodium and excrete potassium. So if they have a the relationship is opposite. I mean, when you have more potassium in plasma, that will have an opposing effect on the secretion of aldosterone. That means it decreases the secretion of aldosterone. But when you have less concentration of potassium, that will cause what? See, the aldosterone causes excretion of potassium. Okay. So, if there are more potassium that will cause stimulation of the aldosterone to cause its excretion. If there are less potassium, so that will inhibit the secretion of aldosterone, so that more potassium is not excreted. ठीक है, तो ये हम लोग देखेंगे कैसे कैसे क्या होता है. सपोज इफ यू हैव इंक्रीज प्लाज्मा कंसेंट्रेशन, सो वॉट इट विल डू, द बॉडी विल वॉन्ट टू स्क्रीट मोर. सो इफ देयर कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ प्लाज्मा कंसेंट्रेशन इंक्रीज बाई 0.5 मिली इक्विवेलेंट पर लीटर, इमीडिएटली रेज द प्लाज्मा अल्डोस्टेरोन लेवल बाई थ्री फोल्ड, सो दैट द हाई लेवल ऑफ द प्लाज्मा पोटाशियम कैन बी एक्रीटेड. It is important to note that an increase in dietary potassium from 40 to 200, so you are increasing the potassium level. So what do you expect? You expect increase in the aldosterone level also, so that it can be excreted. They will increase the plasma aldosterone level to 6-fold. Decrease in plasma potassium, that will increase, that will lower the aldosterone secretions. Mechanism of potassium effect on aldosterone secretion. Potassium is reported to stimulate aldosterone secretion by direct action on Jonah globular cells. It causes depolarization of the cell membrane, causing the opening of. So this potassium will cause depolarization of the membrane, and this depolarization will cause voltage-dependent calcium channel to open and increase in intracellular calcium. So potassium causes this voltage dependent calcium channel. Why voltage? Because this causes depolarization, and depolarization is a change in voltage, and because of this change, the calcium, which is calcium channel, which is a voltage dependent, will open and there will be influx of the calcium. Hence calcium channel blocker can inhibit. So treatment we can give sometimes when there is an excess of aldosterone secretion, and we have when we want to stop the excess of aldosterone secretion, we can give calcium channel blocker. Okay, calcium channel blocker. Role of ACTH. Unlike secretion of glucocorticoid from zona fasciculata and zona reticularis, someone was asking that. I gave in MCQs that glucocorticoid secretion from where. So it is not only secreted in fasciculata, it is also secreted in the reticularis. Of course a small amount, but yes, it is secreted. Okay, now what is the role of ACTH here? The secretion of aldosterone from the zona globularis is primarily independent, very important, independent of the ACTH control. Okay, ACTH but plays the following role in mineralocorticoid secretion. So direct it is not been affected, but how ACTH plays a role in this aldosterone secretion or mineralocorticoid secretion is that indirectly it can control. How? ACTH plays an atonic role in maintaining the aldosterone output. When ACTH is deficient, zona glomulosa is less able to respond to its primary stimulus angiotensin II. So it has been seen experimentally that when you have less ACTH, the zona glomulosa will respond less to the stimulated. And what is that stimulus? Angiotensin II and a potassium. Even there is an angiotensin II, even there is a potassium, but this zona glomulosa will respond less. Why? Because it needs the blessing of the ACTH. So ACTH in that way can control. The direct stimulating effect of the ACTH on aldosterone secretion is mild and transient. Glucocorticoid remediable aldosteronism, GRA, is a recently described syndrome. Now this is a recent things which I also do not know about this. Let's study what is this. Okay, I have heard for the first time. GRA, glucocorticoid remediable aldosteronism. This is a recently described syndrome which occurs due to autosomal dominant disorder. Now, in this condition, there is increase in aldosterone secretion and hypertension produced by ACTH. So, aldosterone secretion is also there, and ACTH secretion will also cause hypertension. So, hypertension is there and aldosterone secretion is there. The gene that encodes for aldosterone synthesis and 11 beta hydroxylase are 95% identical. In patient with GRA, these genes for 11 beta hydroxylase and genes for aldosterone synthase get fused. So what happened? They are telling you that the gene which goes for aldosterone synthesis enzyme, okay, that will form aldosterone, and 11 beta hydroxylases are sometimes identical, and but this in syndrome, this type of disease, these two genes get fused. These two gets fused, and ACTH sensitive aldosterone synthase is the product of the hybrid gene. Okay, so now this aldosterone synthase, previously it was not ACTH sensitive, but when it get fused with the 11 beta hydroxylase, it becomes ACTH sensitive. The hyperaldosteronism and hypertension in GRA can be remedied by suppression of ACTH secretion and administration of glucocorticoids. So when you are suppressing the ACTH, because ACTH sensitive aldosterone synthase is there, if your ACTH is there, that will sensitize the aldosterone synthase to form aldosterone, and hence aldosteronism. But when we can inhibit this ACTH secretion or suppress this ACTH secretion, they can now not sensitize the aldosterone synthase, and hence aldosterone will be controlled. Okay, so we can give by suppressing this ACTH and with the administration of glucocorticoids. Your glucocorticoids, when we give, it will have a long looper feedback, negative feedback effect, and it will decrease the secretion of ACTH. Hence, to decrease the aldosterone, sometimes we give glucocorticoids. Okay, and sometimes to decrease the aldosterone secretion, we sometimes give glucocorticoids. And you know how it is, by decreasing ACTH. ACTH also stimulates secretion of hydrocortisone from zona fasciculata. So now, don't say that hydrocortisone is not formed in, you know, zona fasciculata. Hydrocortisone also formed. It is a, you know, some kind of byproduct of many steroids, which has also a very mild mineralocorticoid activity. Okay. Adrenal sex steroids, they include DHEA and its sulfur ester. DHEA means dihydroepiandrosterone and androstenedione. These are important terms that you should remember. They are important sex steroids. They major androgenic precursor products of adrenal cortex. They themselves are weak androgens. Okay, they are weak androgens. Testosterone, not like testosterone. Okay, they are weak androgen. The DHEA and androstenedione is a weak androgen, but they sometimes can be converted into potent androgen testosterone in peripheral tissues. Okay. Now, estrogen and progesterone are produced in very small amounts. So, apart from this DHEA and androstenedione, we have estrogen and progesterone also, but in a very less amount. It is important to note that the normal human adrenal cortex does not secrete physiologically effective. That means, physiologically effective means what? That means, they are not as potent as estrogen, progesterone and testosterone. Not as potent. And when we say physiologically, that means they cannot produce the sexual, you know, symptoms. They cannot produce the sexual growth that other potent sex steroids can do. Okay. But yes, if there are excess secretion of these, you know, sex steroids, they can produce that effect. Okay. Now synthesis. How adrenaline sex steroids precursors are synthesized in juvenile endocrines. The steps involved in synthesis of androgen precursors are summarized in the figure that we will see. The 17 hydroxylate derivatives of pregnenolone and progesterone are starting points of the for the synthesis of androgen precursors. So now all steroids for that sake are derived from the pregnenolone. So here also 17 hydroxyl derivative of pregnenolone and progesterone, 17 hydroxyl derivative, these are the starting point for the what? These are the starting point for the androgen. Depicting composite synthesis of adrenal cortex hormone, it is 17 hydroxylation is the last reaction common to the synthesis of the cortisol and adrenal androgen. So this sometimes it is asked, is sex steroids, other steroids, cortisol, they are also formed from the same mechanism, but what are the common reaction, last reaction from which one is formed cortisol and other there is a adrenal androgen, depending upon the which enzyme acts on it. It is 17 hydroxylation. This step is the last common step. Now the circumstances that lead to the impairment of cortisol synthesis at any point beyond this step causes accumulation. So if we have studied about, you know, cortisol synthesis, we have flowchart also. Agar there is any disturbance or a block in those synthesis of cholesterol, steroids, glucocorticoids, now they will shift this product, progesterone or pregnenolone, towards the forming sex steroids. You see here, like I'll show you the figure. कोलेस्ट्रॉल से प्रोजेस्टेरोन बना, प्रोजेस्टेरोन प्रोजेस्टेरोन बनाया, 17 हाइड्रोक्सिल पेगनोल, ये सब तो कॉमन स्टेप है यहाँ तक. उसके बाद ये हाइड्रोक्सिलेशन से अकॉर्डिंग टू द एंजाइम, डिफरेंट एंजाइम हेयर, दिस वन, दिस स्टेप, दिस हाइड्रोक्सिलेशन स्टेप विल कॉज फॉर्मेशन ऑफ डिहाइड्रोएपीन डिस्टेरोन डीएचईए और इफ सल्फेटेड इज नोन एज डीएचईएस. You can see here now what I was talking about, the blockage and all. Now this figure is very important actually. MCQs में ना अगर aldosterone का जो MCQ आता है, हम लोग PG में, you know, you have to rectify कर लो, इस figure को rectify कर लो. आज नहीं तो कल ये बहुत काम देने वाला है, ठीक है. With enzymes, everything. कोलेस्ट्रॉल ये तुम्हें इमेज पर गूगल करोगे तो मिल जाएगा, कोई ऐसा नहीं कि यहाँ से स्क्रीन शॉट ले सकते हो, या गूगल करोगे तो मिल जाएगा, ठीक है. कोलेस्ट्रॉल, लेट्स रिवाइज इट, 20 to 22 डेसिमोलेज विल फॉर्म द प्रेगनेनॉन. प्रेगनेनॉन अंडर द स्टिमुलेशन ऑफ द 17 अल्फा हाइड्रोक्सिलेज इट फॉर्म्स वॉट, it forms 17 hydroxypregnenolone and this will form DHEA. This will form DHEA. Now pregnenol under the formation of 3 beta dehydroxygenase, it will form progesterone, and in the presence of enzyme this also converts to 17 hydroxy progesterone. So hydroxy derivative, 17 hydroxy derivative, we have studied above, 17 hydroxy derivative of pregnenol and progesterone, not 11 deoxy, not 20, not this product, it is 17 hydroxylase derivative of pregnenolone and progesterone can form DHEA and androgesterone dione. Okay, now progesterone can form 11 deoxy corticosterone, then corticosterone form dietic corticosterone here, or from here it will form 17 hydroxy progesterone, it will form 11 deoxy derivative, it will form cortisol. So we have here mineralocorticoid, glucocorticoid and sex corticoids here. So these are the precursor, these are the common precursor for this. Okay, now androstenedione dione, and they are both under the influence of aromatase and dehydrogenase isomerase, can give osterone or testosterone, aromatase estradiol. Okay, these all are sex esterides, sex esterides and derivatives of the sex esterides. Plasma level, plasma level normal DHEA is 150 to 200 microgram per cent at 25 years for both sexes. So if someone says that sex esteroids or the androgen cannot be formed in the female, that is wrong. DHEA, if somehow can, under the effect of aromatase, can give rise to male sex hormone in the female also. That's why sometimes some females have hairs, axillary hairs, they have more like a male pattern, they have beard sometime, they have hair on the, you know, lips, above the lips. So all these sometimes are the disbalance of the hormone androgens or the sex esteroids, right? So what is the contribution of adrenal glands to other sex esteroids? If we talk about the fetal life, when a fetus is in uterus, the adrenal cortex is hyperplastic and secretes large amount of DHEAs. And this acts as a, why? Because it's as the main precursor for the synthesis of estrogen by the placenta. Okay. So this DHEA helps in formation of estrogen in the placenta of the fetus, right? So fetal life is very active. This adrenal cortex is very active and hence hyperplastics. Adult woman, adrenal glands supply only 50-60% of the androgenic hormone requirement. DHEAS contributes to increased muscle mass, growth of pubic hair, axillary hair and libido. So this DHEAS, the sulfated forms, if they are increased, you know, the when the ladies go to a gym and they increase their muscle mass, so what they are actually increasing the serum content of DHEAS, formation of synthesis of DHEAS. Okay, they go growth of pubic and axillary hair and libido. Libido means what? Desire for the sexual intercourse. This is libido. The further conversion of androgen precursor to estrogen in the adrenal cortex is not significant before the menopause. Okay. Before the menopause, this conversion is not important. Okay? But in fetal life, it is very, very, very important. Now, after menopause, it becomes of some importance. How? This estrogen activity is provided by the estrogen secreted from the adrenal cortex and that arising from the conversion of androgen precursor in the peripheral tissues. A male mein kya role hai iska? Since testis produces large quantity of testosterone, so biologically, physiologically, the adrenal androgen precursor are of real importance. However, they are important for male sex organ. Thoda effect hota hai, but important. Not more important than the testosterone. Tumor of adrenal cortex. Now, it is associated with the excessive secretion of adrenal androgen. If there is a tumor of adrenal cortex, mainly in the zona reticularis, there will be increase in, you know, secretion of adrenal androgen, and that will cause prepubertal male. What is prepubertal male? Occurrence of such tumors produces precocious puberty. So in prepubertal male, it means they are matured much faster. The puberty age of the male is around what? The male puberty is more than female. Female, I think it is 8 to 9 years and 11 to 12 years in the male. So this tumor will cause precocious puberty. precursor property means what? Precursor property means pseudo property. Precursor pseudo property means there are so much adrenal sex corticosteroids that will affect the male, not only male female also, but the sex organs. So that you know, you have in the before you achieve your, you know, puberty, before you achieve your puberty, you will have, a male will have a more lengthy, you know, sex organ like that of that in a adolescent. The clitoris in the female will have more, you know, hypertrophy than in the, you know, pubertal life. It is before the puberty only they will develop more clitoral hypertrophy or more, you know, muscle mass, hairs, axillary pubic hairs. All this happens in the pubic, puberty. But before puberty only all these things will happen. That is because of a tumor of adrenal cortex. Metabolism and excretion. The metabolism of androgen in general involves reduction of the 3-ketone group and A ring in the liver. We have known that cholesterol is the main, you know, ring. They have 4 rings from which these esteroids are being derived. Aldosterone and etiocholinerone are 2 isomers that are formed as an end result of the metabolism. And excreted in the urine. So these are the metabolic product of the aldosterone, etiocholinerone, and they are excreted in the urine. These metabolites are not specific for adrenal gland. They are produced from other gonadal, organ also. DHEAS is entirely excreted directly in the urine and is virtually adrenal specific. This etiocholinerone could be formed from elsewhere also, but DHEAS is specific to the adrenal. And together, these DHEAS and etiocholinerone and aldosterone, they are surrounding corticosteroids and constitute a major part of the urinary fraction. Okay, they are present in urine. So last class we will take the applied aspects. So we are nearly at the end of the topic chapters. Okay, then after this applied aspect of the adrenal cortex, we will study the hormone of adrenal medulla. We have a Cushing syndrome here. Please read it in advance. Cushing syndrome. We have see all this figure, test for Cushing syndrome and all. We'll all study all this. Okay. So thank you so much.